Kaivalya narakayate tidasa purva akasa puspayate duddantendriya kala sarpa patali pratkhata dangstrayate vidhi mahendaddischa kitayate vishvam purna sukhayate yat korona kataksha vaibhavatam yat korona kataksha vaibhavatam tam gauram stumaham. Kaivalya narakayate tidasa purva akasa puspayate duddantendriya kala sarpa patali pratkhata dangstrayate vidhi mahendaddischa kitayate vishvam purna sukhayate yat korona kataksha vaibhavatam tam gauram eva stumaham. Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad told that this material world is a place where painful testing can be done for us all. Gauriya Goshtipati Srila Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur Prabhupad told this material world is a place where painful testing can be done for all jivas. If you can survive after that testing, then we can think you can do bhajan or not bhajan. That's different thing. But first of all, severe testing, painful testing, you will have to go through painful testing. In this material world, you cannot expect any kind of, you know, actual peace, any kind of actual bliss, not possible. But still, bonded soul always searching here in this material world like blind. A blind man searching this ultimately can find nothing, because they are not going to follow pure Guru Vaishnava properly. This also a question of luck. Kyunki, why? Brahmanda bhramite kono bhagyavan jeev. Brahmanda bhramite kono bhagyavan jeev. Guru Krishna prasade paye bhakti lata bij. It's a rare case. Very, very rare case. If you think, Maharaj, I am trying to cut maya, someday I can come out successful. But be sure, if you are not going to come out successful this life to cut maya, then you will have to take birth again. Again and again you will have to take birth. Yahaiva tair jitam jesam samme sthitam manaha. Yahaiva tair jitam. You will have to cut maya by the power of Guru Vaishnava. This life, now, not after 8 years of age, not that. Because when you can start bhajan? If you are going to delay, waste your time to cut maya. So, when you can start your actual bhajan, that is the main problem. So, actually, Sri Krishna Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, that's why in Sikkhastakam first log told, all jivas, they are feeling some pain, mental agony, painful situation there. Because they are fighting with each other, no peace is there inside their heart. How to reach Supreme Lord? It is not possible. That's why in first slok Chaitanya Mahaprabhu told, Cheto Darpana Marjanam Adi Bhava Mahadabagni Nirvaparam. Everywhere forest fire going. Oh, here is forest. Where, Maharaj? It is forest. This is forest. I mean, no, not forest, but more than forest. Excuse me, more than forest. Actually, this is not forest, I know. Forest is there, remote place, there are tiger and elephant, all very dangerous animals staying there. But in this society, more dangerous animals are there. But they have two legs, two hands, two eyes. They are more dangerous than those beasts there, dangerous animals staying there. That's why somebody started suggesting, Maharaj, you all sadhu, you will have to go to forest to meditate. And yes, I was supposed to go to forest, but our Guru Varga speaking that for a nice doctor, if there is any nice doctor, what is the utility if I send a nice doctor to forest? No use. A doctor should stay in front of all people so that if there is any disease, they can recognize, they can detect, and try to give remedy, try to find solution of that disease. So that is why I many times told, Prahlad Maharaj also speaking same thing. There usually it is seen that those sadhus, they are flying to forest, hilly place to meditate, solitary bhajan. But O Nisingadev, I am not so selfish. I am here to arrange kipa, your kipa for all. That is the duty of Guru Vaishnava. That is the duty of Guru Vaishnava to arrange kipa for others. That's why Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur many times told to seek to arrange the good for this whole world and material world. We, one member of this Gauriya society, Gauriya Math, must be ready to shed gallons of blood for the emancipation of those bonded souls there in the ocean of misery. So, like fire brigade man will have to catch their head, catch their hair and deliver. So, Saraswati Thakur speaking, each and every member of Gauriya Math should get ready to shed gallons of blood for the emancipation of those, you know, common people, bonded people of this world. So merciful they are. One Gauriya Math devotee, big Gauriya Math devotee, they are so merciful that I cannot explain it in front of you. Not any amount of philosophy is not just sufficient to explain this, you know, fact in front of you. So Prahlad Maharaj speaking, Prayana Deva Munayo Sabamukta Kama Maunam Charanti Vijanena Parathanishta Naitana Vyahayo Kipanana Vimuksha Eka Nanyan Tadasa Saranam Brahmatonu Pasri. You can remember many times I told. That's why, hey Prabhu, we cannot find any solution for those bonded souls. So we will have to arrange some good for them. That's why Prahlad Maharaj Vaishnav praying in front of Nisingadev. That's why Nisingadev can consider the case. Vaishnavero avedane krishnatayamoy ehano pramorpati haiben sadai. If Vaishnav is not satisfied with me, if Vaishnav not going to apply in front of Supreme Lord for me, if Vaishnava not going to apply for me in front of Supreme Lord, then there is no chance. There is no chance. In Kirtan, Bhakti Vinod Thakur also writing so many Kirtan. Or if I think I am myself a big sadhu, who you are? In that case, Bhakti Vinod Thakur writing, what kind of appealing mood, what kind of humility should be there? Humility. There Bhakti Vinod Thakur writing, Ami to Vaishnava e buddhi hoile, amani naham ami. If I think I am a Vaishnava, then I can never become humbler than a blade of grass. I cannot so. Then in that case, the question of bhajan is far away. We cannot expect to start bhajan any time. So, you can remember from Gita I was speaking just a few minutes ago. Ihaiva toi rijitam jesham sam isthitam manaha. in this very life, very quickly, now, because there is no surety of your life, how long you are going to live, there is no surety. So now, at ease, you have to think about your faults. Right now, you will have to arrange so that you can get kripa of Guru Vaishnav and go up to that level to do Hari Bhajan. That is the question. So now question is that day I was speaking, that actually we are enjoying liberty, huh? We are enjoying liberty, no? Everybody think, I am enjoying liberty. Who are you to speak? Yes, you are enjoying liberty. But that liberty is very, very dangerous. Why? But because this liberty is actually, if you go very minutely, you can see this liberty is the cause of your tight bondage. Very tight bondage. Na tathasya bhavet bandho, bandhascha anya prasangata, yashit sangadi yatha pungso tatha tatsangi sangataha. It is written in Srimad Bhagavatam, na tathasya bhavet bandho, bandhascha anya prasangata, yashit sangadi yatha pungso tatha tatsangi sangataha. What is the topmost bondage in your life? But that I am explaining actually from Gita, Prabhupad speaking, Vishwanacha Godwell speaking. Na tatha svabhavet bandha. That kind of bondage you can never expect. It's not possible. What kind of bondage? If you are going to get yoshit sangha. Yoshit sangha is the topmost reason, the cause of your topmost bondage. You can never expect that kind of bondage. Maybe you have some false ego because you are very beautiful to look or very handsome to look. Maybe you are from a nice family heritage. Maybe you have educational qualification. Maybe you have money, everything. All those are the cause of bondage. That day I was speaking, no? That day I was speaking, you can remember. Jovanam dhanasampatti prabhuttam avivekitaha. Ekoikam opi anarthayo kimuto yasto chatushtayam. One out of these four can put you in danger. What to speak about all the four qualities of Jovanan, very worth age. Like you can remember that Nalkubor was very young age, very nice looking, very big opulences there with them. Kuberatmajaha. So they are expressing, you know, negligency. They are expressing some, you know, very, very bad manner. Want to disregard Naraji Maharaj. Actually, those Sadhu Guru Vaishnav never want to get any respect from anybody. Because the basic thing you are not going to understand, the Amani Manat. I can explain on those coming days what is the mentality of Prabhupada. What Prabhupada wanted to teach us. I mean the actual teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. If you want to get the exact teaching, exact scientific teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, you will have to follow Bhakti Vinod Thakur, you will have to follow Prabhupada. No other way. No alternative I can prescribe. The only way, you have to follow Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Thakur, Prabhupada. So I can explain what is the, you know, Siddhanta of Prabhupada. Prabhupada in very craving mood. Very craving mood, Prabhupada speaking in front of those, you know, disciples. But Prabhupada never speak that they are my disciple. I have never heard from my Guru Padma, you are my disciple. Never. Not even a single time in whole life. I never hear from Srila Paramahansa Ajaya Bhakti Pumat Purikasya, never. He with folded hands speaking, Baba, I am not your Guru. Actually, Jagat Guru Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati Goswami Prabhupada, I offer all those jivatma, you, he, all, offer as a Puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. Actually, your guru is Prabhupada. I am not guru. Many times told. It is my duty to get some flower, beautiful flower, from garden, and to offer unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada, my Gurudev. That I have done. You all coming to me to do Hari Bhajan, this is all Jivatma is like flower. I collect and give Puspanjali unto the lotus feet of Prabhupada. He can take all your responsibility. This way with heavy heart, Guru Padmini used to speak, sometimes crying. I am not Guru, I am not Guru, I am not Guru. Also Prabhupada speaking that way. Also I can describe Prabhupada speaking in front of all those disciples that actually you all are my Guru, Shiksha Guru, helping me different way, one or other, different way. You all are helping me in my Guru Seva. You are all my Guru, Shiksha Guru. Sometimes speaking, you are all my Bipod Uddharan Bandhu. I am in danger in Maya. So you are all watching me so that I am not going to fall down. This is the darshan of a pure Gurudev. This is the darshan of a Paramahansa Gurudev. A Paramahansa Gurudev can never express any kind of vanity, any kind of false ego. It's not possible. Actually, this Vaishnava Dharma, each and every fraction of second, we will have to cry, we will have to repent for our inability, ayogyata. Each and every fraction of second, we will have to cry. The yogyata vichare kichu nahi pai, tomaro koruna saru. If you want to, you know, see my quality, then sure, you are not going to bestow your kippa on me. I am unqualified, 100%. But your causeless mercy is the only thing on which I can believe. That's why I have come to you on lotus feet. Yogyata vichare kichu nahi pai, tomaro koruna saru. Your causeless mercy is the only supporting thing in my life. That's why Prabhupada used to explain this way, that you are all helping me to get steady in my bhajan, always. You are watching me. If I make even slight mistake, what is the symptom of Sadguru? What is the symptom of Sadguru? Foolish people, they cannot understand. And also it is true, I am not going to criticize anybody. I have no desire to criticize. But how to do? Then I will have to represent the darshan in such a way, so that at least you can understand something. If you have something, some kippa. Without kippa, your brain power cannot support. I am sorry. You will have to see that everybody running behind him. He is Sadguru. How to understand? If you find he is making some mistake in Siddhanta, be careful. Very, very vital point. Very, very vital point. We are fighting against Maya. So very moderate way we'll have to approach. Not like a freedom fighter. I can give fire and boom, boom on your... Not. This is not the possible. Humble yet steady, very humble way. I can explain so that you can shed your tears, what Prabhupada was speaking. So you see that yogyata vichare kichu nahi pai. If you find some guru, everybody speaking is Jagat Guru, who is going to stop whom? We are enjoying liberty. If you speak, if you are going to interfere with my liberty, I can slap you, I can beat you, I can cut you and throw into ocean. So this is the definition of our liberty. We cannot allow to speak about the absolute truth. That is our result of our. And I never heard this word democracy in any shastra. I never heard this word democracy in any all shastra I search, nowhere. Where from you are getting this democracy, I don't know. Because this democracy can ultimately prove you autocracy. Autocracy, this democracy is not a good. Actually, it is a funny. If you explain, those political leaders, if you ask what is the meaning of this democracy, democracy means we are all king in our kingdom. Who are you? Rabindranath Tagore, writing very nice way. Those who are Bengali people hearing, they can laugh. Amra sabai raja amader ei rajar rajotte. Amra sabai, we all are king in our kingdom. So who is going to rule whom? This is the condition. Amra sabai raja, we all king. This is the ultimate, you know, point of democracy. Maybe 70% or 80% result you can get in European country or here, there, some. But though in country where the percent of illiterate is very high, no question, and they are all in ignorant. So actually, point is there that there actually then in the it is like ideal gas. You gone through chemistry and physics, ideal gas you gone, huh? Don't foolish. Ideal gas don't know. Ideal means it is not possible. It is ideally there, Kelvin scale. According to Kelvin scale, there is one standard yardstick, one standard setup that this gas can be called ideal gas. But up to now in this whole universe, nobody can show what is ideal gas. It is one standard set. Follow. But it's not in actually not possible. Ideal gas is not possible in practical. That's why I am bound to say that this democracy, it not possible in practical. Theoretically you can say, but practically you cannot prove that is 100% success. That the thing 2-3 days ago I was speaking, you can remember, nashanti nashanti anayaka nashanti bahunayaka nashanti kunayaka nashanti kunayaka. When Benraja was a king there, then all problem take place. Oh my God, all energy everywhere, all problem. Then what to do? Then Rishi Munis, they like to give some idea to him. He become very popped up. Oh, you are to worship me. I am king. Where is God? Foolish you are. You are worshipping God. Who is God? I am. King is God. Then Rishi Muni think he is so too much popped up. What to do? What is the solution? He is not at all going to obey. Then they burn him up. Follow? When Kunayak, and the very dangerous leader was there, that was also a problem. When the dangerous leader gone, then also more problem there. There is no king all everywhere, you know. That is also. And where you can find so many people to get control over the situation, then there is also a problem. Bahunayaka. That is the key, that is the situation with this democracy. We are all there. He is going to do some good thing. Well, we can charge bomb and, you know, break his head so that he cannot do. This is the situation, this is the result of. So it is one kind of autocracy. Autocracy, actually. So what is the solution? If we can somehow can get a very pious king, somehow, if we are lucky to get a pious king like Parikshit Maharaj, Pitu Maharaj, Janak Maharaj, you know, Ambarish Maharaj, then we are lucky. Oh, now it's okay. Because you can think about the good of whole society, like Ramchandra teaching, like children. All people staying in my whole country, they are all my children. I will shake up. my personal benefit, my personal honor, my personal benefit, nothing I'm going to think about that. Only the thing I will have to, only the thing we have to think that the my, you know, those who are staying in my country, they are happy or not. How to arrange, you know, situation in such a way they can feel comfortable. That is the duty of a king. At present also, some Arabian country I heard, there is 1 point tax. Everywhere where you go, there is free. Or 1 point tax. Everywhere, in one country, all free. Anywhere you go, no problem. All poor and, you know, mediocre, all everybody is enjoying some. Now, actually, point is that the situation of this, our devotional field, is so critical, not to speak. We have to realize. Now I can go back to the point. Again, I can go come back to the point of Sanatana Dharma. Oh, okay, first I let me discuss this point. Someday, Dronachal Parvat, someday Dronachal Parvat asking in front of Hanumanji Maharaj, follow. Hanumanji Maharaj is Gyaninam Barishtha, is a topmost knowledgeable person. But he identifies himself in a very humble way. I am actually a beast, I do nothing. But he is Gyaninam Barishtha. That Hanumanji Maharaj one day went there, so Dronachal Parvat giving service to him, and after that asking, Hanumanji Maharaj, we have one question. What question? We like to get exact explanation of Sanatana Dharma. Why I am making this field? Why I am making background to come to conclusion? If you are foolish, you cannot understand. Why Maharaj going so, covering so big field to come to the conclusion? Otherwise, you cannot understand the Siddhanta. Maybe you can become angry with me. So, actually, Dronachal Parvat asking in front of Hanumanji Maharaj, Maharaj, we would like to hear exact definition of Sanatana Dharma. Hanumanji Maharaj speaking very gladly, oh, really? Krite pratikritam esha dharmo sanatanaha. Krite pratikritam. You have done something from me. I am grateful to you. This gratefulness, this humbleness, is the basic thing of Sanatana. Mind it. Very scientific point. Hanumanji Maharaj speaking, Krite pratikritam esha dharmaha sanatanaha. If somebody is doing something to me, I must be grateful. That day I was speaking 3-4 days before, whenever you take birth in this material world, automatically three kind of, you know, you have day in debt you have to pay. Rishirin, Pitrin, Devarin, Bhutarin. How different way you will have to pay? You will have to pay. Otherwise no respite. But there is one but. What is that? If you are going to dedicate your life for the cause of Guru Vaishnava Bhagavan, then nobody going to chase you. You are not going to be responsible for anything what is happening in the whole material world. Let happen. You are going to serve Bhagavan, Supreme Lord. That's why you can remember, I told many times before, that Jatha taroramol nisechanena tippanti tatkanda bhujopusakha pranopuharascha jathandriyanam tataiva sarva arahanam achyutejya. Achyutejya, I mean Prabhu, Supreme Lord, and His paraphernalia, dhamnam, all total one tattva. If you can cut one devotee, insult one devotee, throw, then you are going to cut your own throat. Be careful. You are going to commit suicide. You can insult. You are enjoying liberty. You can insult somebody. But this insult man can come into your, in your life as a trident. Trident, no? Like Mahadev giving trident, Trishul. Whole life you are going to cry. Next after, next after, next after. Oh, no respite. So, Hanumanji Maharaj speaking in such scientific way that we will have to remember our Siddhanta given by Chaitanya Mahaprabhu also. Also, really so, we are always indebted to our father and mother, always to our guardian. We receive some guidance from them, anyway material. Somehow, someday somebody wanted to help me. I was in a bad situation. So every time in my life, you have to be grateful. Gratefulness is the main thing of Krishna Bhajan. Gratefulness, humility, humbleness is the main object in the way of your Hari Bhajan. You cannot, you should not forget. If you forget, very dangerous. Now I come to the point. If you see that he is enjoying big, you know, reputation all over the world, but he is making some Siddhanta Virodh. We find some Siddhanta Virodh there. Those who are going to enjoy some facility out of his reputation, mind it. We are so big businessmen, we like to use our Guru Vaishnav as our business trade of name and fame. I can grow, it's very easy. So I can try to prove that I am near and dear one of this Vaishnav. You know? You don't know? So you should respect me. So Prabhupada speaking, in front of Gaurakisha Babaji Maharaj, some useless people always used to stay all around. Gaurakisha Babaji Maharaj never wanted to throw them, hey, go away! Never wanted to speak. Gaurakisha Babaji Maharaj doing his own bhajan, let them stay. Prabhupada speaking, outside foolish people, they can think that those outside people, those useless people, they are near and dear one of this Gaurakisha Babaji Maharaj, Paramahansa Maharaj. They can think that way, that they are serving this Paramahansa Maharaj, so we have our duty to serve them. But internally, if you search, they are doing all women association, all kind of bad activities they are doing. So foolish people can take decision according to their guru. Who is their guru? Who is their guru? Their material mind is their guru. Their material mind is their guru. So they are going to follow. Crazy mind. Okay, you do it. Do it. You do it. You can do it. Follow. This way they are doing everything like crazy. So it is our natural, you know, Brahmo, Pramad, Vipralipsha, Karna, Patav. This, those are the four different kind of defects. Usually staying with bonded soul. Not usually 100% staying. Without these defects, these three, four defects, you cannot find a man who is free from these four different kind of defects. If you find he is free from four different kind of these four defects, be sure he is not ordinary man. So, sometimes we find that those some big acharya, who is famous all over the world, making wrong Siddhanta. Totally wrong Siddhanta. But still we cannot chase him directly. But he is enjoying. Who is going to obey me? But if I represent this philosophy in a very scientific way, I think reasonable, you know, conception is there with you. So you can understand preliminary Siddhanta. So if you find there's some big people there, they're enjoying reputation, making Siddhanta Virod, be sure they are not actually Siddha Mahatma. Be sure. They are not Siddha Mahatma. Maybe they are doing bhajan, making some odd remarks, which is not at all possible for a devotee to pass that kind of remark, not possible. This way, each and every time, you are in trouble. How to detect? So, in Chaitanya Charitamrita, I told you, you can find one word. Kayamana vakye kare udvegna dibe. That day I was speaking. Kayamana vakye kare udvegna dibe. By body, speech and mind, you should not give any, you know, pain to anybody. You cannot put anybody in trouble, anxiety. Kai monobakko, by body, speech and mind, it is not your duty. But this is the advice of Chaitanya Charitamrita, we know it. But maximum people going to take advantage, undue advantage of this world. Maximum, you know, people, they are going to take undue advantage of this world. They are going to say, there it is written, you are giving anxiety to everybody, but you don't know. If you approach a doctor, if it is necessary to, you know, to give some operation to you, I will have to do it. Maybe you are shouting, leave me, leave me, leave me, I don't need operation, but I will have to do it operation, then you can shout. Because the previous day, there was no system of anesthesia. Anesthesia was discovered after, but before, there was no. So all four or five people can catch you forcefully, can cut, and you can sight and you can shout and cry, but still they are holding you very, and operate, and give apply medicine and bandage. This is the duty of Guru Vaishnava. That is why Jagannath Babaji Maharaj crying and speaking. Those who are pure Guru Vaishnava, they have no self-interest. All the time they are trying to give benefit to those common people out of their absolute speech, Harikatha. But unluckily, they all think he is our enemy. Beat him, cut him. We are very unlucky that we think that Vaishnava is our enemy. That is a painful situation of this world. So most of the people, those who are going to lead, give you some leading part, playing some leading part, they always want to cite this example that kayamono bakye kare udvegna dibe. They are going to take undue advantage of this word and they like to misuse this Siddhanta, like to guide wrong way. But actually, point is there, kaimono bakke kare udbeg nibe na dibe, if we are going to take some undue advantage of this sloka, then it is, don't try to stop speaking about the absolute truth with the help of this undue advantage of this sloka. You are going to take advantage of the undue advantage of this sloka and you are going to stop speaking about the absolute truth. That is a danger with you. This sloka doesn't mean that you will have to hide the absolute truth. That doesn't mean I can allow you to stay in anartha, full of anartha. Try to remember again and again what I told before. Prabhupada speaking, a Sadguru never going to initiate you, at the same time he is not to keep you in anartha. Follow. Sadguru not going to initiate in such a way so that all anartha can stay as it is with you. Follow what I say. It is not the duty of a Sadguru. Be careful. Maybe they can try to prove that we are more merciful, but they are not at all merciful. It is one kind of jiva hingsa. Physical assault is jiva hingsa, but I told you, to misguide people is more than that. It is dangerous jivhingsa. Because jivhingsa means to do some wrong, you know. Jivhingsa means you are going to show some, you know, such activities so that they can never go up to the level of full consciousness. This you are going to arrange, and at the same time you are going to give some different kind of advantage, privilege. I am giving you, oh really, then I can admit you as Sadguru. But Sadguru is not such a, you know, mane ravish tattva. Sadguru is not a... So, with the undue advantage of this sloka, don't try to stop speaking about the Absolute Truth. That is my request in front of you all. This is a request in front of you all. Don't try to take undue advantage of this sloka and misguide people. That is the main thing. So, actually, that day, yesterday, I was discussing so many things. But now I can give so many examples in front of you. You can remember the heart of Vaishnav. When Jadavacharya wanted to kill Ramanujacharya, you can remember? You can remember all I was discussing about Ramanujacharya? That day I was speaking that Ramanujacharya is a very nice acharya, neutral. But Jadavacharya wanted to kill him unnecessarily, simply because out of jealousy, enviousness, wanted to kill him. But I want to give you a reminder that Jadavacharya, when he was bound to approach Ramanujacharya later on life, then Ramanujacharya was ready to accept him as disciple. By the advice of the mother of Jadavacharya. Mother of Jadavacharya speaking, you will have to go and take shelter onto the lotus feet of Ramanuj. Otherwise there is big danger. Then he was bound to approach Ramanujacharya and beg for pardon. Then getting all diksha, everything. After that, he is leading his life very nice way. Follow? This way, each and every time we can find that if there is any aparadh there, if aparadh is not going away from your life, then you are not going to get any concrete result in your bhajan. You cannot get any result in your bhajan. Now point is that bonded soul, we are in this material world, it is called imperfect world. It's not Vaikuntha world. There is Vaikuntha Jagat and Kunthamaya Jagat. Kunthaman, this material is full of hesitation, full of doubts, full of envious attitude, all this. But that Vaikuntha world, there is no such dirty thing is allowed. In Vaikuntha Jagat, yes, of this life. So this is Vaikuntha Jagat, there you cannot expect. So Vaikuntha Jagat mean such a world where this kind of dirty things are not allowed. Dirty things are not allowed there. This is called Vaikuntha Jagat. Vaikuntha Jagat means you are not allowed there. If at all there is dirtiness is there, so you will have to clean your dirtiness there. The sloka I started with is very important sloka, you can remember. Koivallangarakayate tidasa pura kasapuspayate duddantendriya kalo sarpapatali pratkhatadam strayate vidhi mahendadishchakitayate vishampurna sukhayate jat koruna kataksha vaivavatam tan gauramevastamaho. We are going to apply unto the lotus feet of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu this way. In the first sloka of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking, Chaitanya Mahaprabhu speaking that Chetadarpana Marjanam, there is forest fire all around. But here in this sloka, we find that everywhere there is nectar. How possible? Vishwampurna Sukhayate, where you find problem? Where is problem? You always find there is problem, there is problem, there. Nowhere problem. That is a stage of Paramahansakul. That is the last stage of Paramahansa Kul. That stage is very nice. That time you can find everything positive. You cannot find any negative there, all nectar everywhere. That is called actually Vaikuntha Darshan. But material darshan means you can have a mood to take revenge against anybody. This is not the mood of Guru Vaishnava. You cannot speak that way. You speak, then I can remember, I can give you a reminder. 3 days ago I was speaking now one sloka. There I was speaking one sloka from third canto. What is the sloka? In that sloka it is written that Guru Vaishnava going to confine the lotus feet of Supreme Lord inside their heart. Inside their heart. So, if we take trouble to go through Ved, Vedanta and this, that and grow our proficiency, skill to explain Shastra. Sutasya pungsam suchira samasya nanjo sasuri virita artha tattat gunano sabanam mukunda padar vinda hidesh jesham. We are going to follow those acharya, they are going to follow Srimad Bhagavatam. Follow? It is the exact teaching of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Those who are going to follow Srimad Bhagavatam in toto, we are going to follow them. Because it is the strict instruction of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, Srimad Bhagavatam pramanam amalam prema pumartha mahano, Sri Chaitanya Mahaprabhur Matam Idam Tatradharana Paraha. We are not going to honor anything. Any wrong Siddhanta. We are going to follow the Vishuddha Praman. That is called Srimad Bhagavatam. If you are going to follow Srimad Bhagavatam in toto, that means if you are going to follow Bhagavat Parampara, I mean Sauta Parampara, in that case Mahaprabhu become happy with me. Otherwise we cannot expect Mahaprabhu can become very happy with me because I was successful to do this and that, so many jugglery I have shown in front of whole world. You have the capacity to show jugglery in front of whole world. What is concerned to us? But we are going to follow some Siddhanta through which we can understand that who is Sadguru, who is not. We have to understand this one. Because this is the basic thing. Otherwise never we can understand the Siddhanta Vichar of Chaitanya, teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu, we cannot understand. So you see, there actually Srimad Bhagavatam Pramanam Amalam Prema Pumartha Mahano. So you'll have to follow it. Pramanam Amalam, Amal Praman. Mahaprabhu admit, Mahaprabhu confess. So from this Bhagavatam, if I give this example, the Sutta Sapungsam Suchiro Samasana Anjasasuri Virita Artha Tattat Gunanu Sabanam Mukunda Padara Vinda Hidesh Jesham. What does it mean? It means, why you are going to take trouble, waste your time to go through Ved Vedanta? You cannot take decision. Because you are not enjoying full kippah of Sadguru Vaishnava, you cannot come into conclusion. Big danger. So why not you go and serve a pure Guru Vaishnava, Gauriya Guru Vaishnava? Then you can get more and more facility. We can give you an example, direct example. Not one example, I can give countless examples. They are not at all educated. They are not at all educated. Only the thing they have, 100% submission unto the lotus feet of Sadguru. I can give one by one example, two or three. There I can show that how it is possible. Bihari, you know Bihari, he is a sevak of Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. He is a Brajavasi also. All along he is giving service to Jagannath Das Babaji Maharaj. Babaji Maharaj is very happy, but still he is not educated, he is uneducated. Someday Babaji Maharaj speaking, Bihari, I like to hear Bhagavatam. You read Bhagavatam. Bihari say, oh my God, you know already that I am uneducated. You know already I am uneducated. How I can read? I say you read. Sit. Babaji Maharaj speaking this way. I say you read. Sit. Okay, how I can read? I cannot read. I am illiterate. You sit and read. He sit and open Bhagavatam. He started reading Bhagavatam. You cannot believe. Impossible for you to believe. Because always you are going to apply your own logic. I can give another example. Totally illiterate. One of my godbrother, I speak, he is my godbrother. You can never hear from me that nobody is my godbrother. Maybe he is from another guru, but I admit he is my godbrother. Prabhupad Goswami Maharaj. Totally illiterate. He was the gate man of one rich man. When he saw us, Srila Bhaktivedanta Madhav Goswami Maharaj, North Bengal, he totally night time, he threw everything, all your gun and dress, throw, and come and cry in front of Maharaj, Maharaj, you save me. From then onward, he was a Nepali. He was a wrestling master. Very big body. Wrestling master. He used to serve Gurudev very nicely. Very nicely. So actually, Gurudev knowing he has full submission. Gurudev loved him very much. So when he was given sannyas, that time all other of his godbrothers, they wanted to speak to Gurudev. Gurudev, he is uneducated, illiterate. Gurudev, you should not give sannyas. Speaking to Madhav Goswami Maharaj. Madhav Goswami hearing. Not speaking anything. One day, Madhav Maharaj with very harsh voice speaking. If I am not going to give sannyas to Dinabandhu, then Supreme Lord cannot excuse me. They are stunned. What is that? If I am not going to give sannyas to Dinabandhu, then Supreme Lord cannot excuse me. They are all stunned. Really so. He was given sannyas. He was the topmost pracharak. Cannot read anything. The topmost pracharak in Bombay, Bangalore, anywhere if you go, still today, they know the name of Parvat Baba ki Jai Ho. Everywhere. You can go and search. Still today people going there in the name of Parvat Baba. They are so massive. In Brajadham, everybody knowing. You go to Madhuban, yeah, there you know Parvat, Hare Parvat Baba. Everybody knowing. Not only that, whenever he is going in preaching field, whenever? No. All the year he is running in preaching. Only 4 months, Chaturmasa staying in Govardhan. Whole year he is running with Giriraj Maharaj. Giriraj Maharaj is his president. He is putting in bag, going everywhere, asking anything, what to do, what not to do. Is tremendous love for Giriraj Maharaj. By the mercy of Giriraj Maharaj, he got one ashram there. There actually, that Parvat Baba, whenever going to any preaching field, 8 months doing preaching, only 4 months, Chaturmasa not going anywhere. If you pay 1 lakh rupees, still not going. He cannot go. He can stay in one place. And do Hari Bhajan and daily Govardhan Parikrama. Every day doing. Whenever he is going for preaching in Bombay, here, there, nobody knows that he is not educated. He is keeping the book open in front of him and go on speaking all Tattva Siddhanta miracle. our Kesava Goswami are speaking, it is another topics. Aranya Maharaj, one disciple of Prabhupada. Kesava Goswami are speaking. Kesava Goswami himself speaking. Whenever we are going with him for in preaching, when he is giving Harikatha in front of all professor and doctorate, they think he has done big doctorate, delete. They think so. Kesava Goswami is speaking. Whenever he is speaking, they think all the rigor, this must be he has done some delete in philosophy, this, that, but he is not, he cannot sign even. Kesava Goswami is speaking. Kesava Goswami is speaking. So, Kesava Goswami is speaking, so is the power of Prabhupada. So is the, Kesava Goswami is speaking, that is called gratitude. So is the power of Prabhupada, even I am idiot number one. If Prabhupada want to translate some power, I can show some magic spell. For that I cannot speak, I am doing, I cannot say. It's not possible for me to speak that way. Parvat Goswami Maharaj, Parvat Maharaj going anywhere, he is the godbrother of Bhakti Vala of Tattva Goswami Maharaj, Bhakti Vigyan Bharati Maharaj. And my godbrother, 100%. I confess that he is my godbrother. Sitting in Vyasasana and go on speaking. Oh, we Baba. Not knowing anything. Cannot read, cannot write. This is the excellency of Guru Shakti. I know you are not going to believe me, but you will have to believe. Hey. Guru Shakti is so powerful. So now I like to go back to that sloka I was explaining 4 days before. Srutha sapungsam suchira samasana anjo sasuri virithartha. You are going to put trouble to learn this, okay. But if you are going to enjoy full kippa, affection, or Guru Vaishnav, I can explain this point tomorrow. Be sure, all done. All the inner meaning of Shastra can appear inside your heart. Everybody like to insult Prabhupada. Where your Gurudev staying? Eh? This way, they want to prove that your Gurudev is useless. Prabhupada used to say, my Gurudev actually, the permanent address of my Gurudev is the lotus feet of Radharani. But at present, he is manifesting Leena in their Kuliyadip. Kuliyadip. What is the material, you know, what is the qualification of your Gurudev? Actually, in material point of view, we cannot find any qualification of my Gurudev, but be sure, in this whole Brahmanda universe, there is not such a, any single problem which my Guru Padma cannot solve. And flawlessly, not only ordinary solution, flawless solution, he can find of any problem pertaining to this universe. This is the answer, smart answer of my Prabhupada. Follow? This way Prabhupada speaking very smartly in front of those idiot people who want to insult Prabhupada. So Sutasapungsam, this sloka I can explain again. That you are going to take trouble, okay, you are doing, this is also, but you will have to concentrate on Seva. You have to do Seva repeatedly. If you are going to serve pure Guru Vaishnava, then be sure all the inner meaning of all Shastra can manifest inside your heart. You cannot believe because you have no direct evidence. I am giving direct evidence, you cannot believe. Until and unless you are going to feel it in your own life, you can 100%. Like our, you know, philosopher, they are speaking that you cannot understand the pain of snake bite. You can understand? You can understand the pain? What a pain of a patient of snake bite. Only you can say, oh, 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 this much you can say. You can express some consolation, but you have no way to directly feel what is pain. Similar way I would like to say, you cannot feel the heart of Guru Vaishnava, those who are burning their heart because they are hearing the insult of Guru Vaishnava. They are feeling pain. You cannot understand in reality. So actually point is that pure Guru Vaishnava means is their transcendental realm. You cannot go up to that level to realize their heart, to get their heart feeling, to get their feeling. It's not possible for you. So you are going to take trouble so much, but if you are going to follow this, the easiest way to serve pure Guru Vaishnava, then you can understand. Very quickly you can see all the inner meaning of Shastra can manifest. How it is possible that Gaur Kishore Baba is going to explain one Sanskrit Bhagavad sloka in front of Prabhupada? Whereas Prabhupada is speaking, yeah, my Gurudev suddenly one day giving me, requesting me, giving me order, Mamad Prabhu, you can speak one sloka from Bhagavatam? Yes, as you order me. Prabhupada speaking this sloka, one sloka from Bhagavatam. Then Gaur Kishore was speaking, Amar Prabhu, my Prabhu, can we explain this sloka? Yes, why not? Then Prabhupada, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati explaining this sloka. Oh, so nice the meaning. Gaur Kishore Babaji was speaking. Acha, my Prabhu, if I explain this sloka this way, is the meaning okay, very nice or not? Could you please say? Then Gaur Kishore Babaji started explaining the meaning of this sloka. Prabhupada gone mad. Who told? Who is going to say that Babaji Maharaj is illiterate? Not knowing any Shastra? Oh my God. Explaining in such a way so that all professions are there inside his heart. Then Prabhupada going to pass remark. Who is going to confine Krishna inside his heart? Is there any in lack of any meaning of any Shastra? Shortage? It cannot be. That's the sloka that I was speaking from Upanishad. Yasmin gyate sarvamidam vigyatam bhavati. Yasmin prapte sarvamidam praptum bhavati. Follow. You will have to run in search of that absolute truth. Always try to remember. We are all searching, running to get that absolute truth. In between, Maya can make so many disturbances so that you cannot reach your goal. But you will have to take strong resolution that I can die or do. I can do or die. This is the resolution you have to take in your life. Otherwise, you cannot expect exact guidance from anywhere. You cannot expect exact 100% guidance. What given by Prabhupada? You cannot expect. Most of our Guru Varga gone. So you see, in this Bhagavatam, in this Bhagavat slog, you are giving advice to go for Sadhu Sangha. Not, this is the meaning, na? What is the meaning of this sloka? Ultimately, you are giving advice to go for Sadhu Sangha. Why? Because Sadhu Sangha means always Harikatha. Sadhu Sangha means ki? Sadhu Sangha means always Harikatha. That's why, na, Kapiji Maharaj is speaking in front of Mada, Satang prasangyad mama bijya sangvido bhavanti hitkar narasayana kyataha tajyoshanad ashu apavarga vatmani sradhya bhakti roti ranukramishyati. This is the procedure. So, everywhere in all Shastra you can find the advice of Sadhu Sangha. Everywhere you can find the advice of sadhu sangha sarvasaste koi, labamato sadhu sangha sarvasiddhi hoy. Even we can see the miracle that even Mayavadi Vaishnav Das, he was Mayavadi before, in Jaiva Dharma you can find the case that Vaishnav Das was previously Mayavadi, now due to the Vaishnav Sangha, miracle happens in his life. He become topmost Vaishnav. Topmost Vaishnav in life. So this way you see, sadhu sangha, sarvasaste koi, labamatto sadhu sanghe sarvasiddhi hoy. Now again I can go to the point, who is sadhu, who is not. From whole world this question coming to me. Every time, same question. I am giving answer. They are so foolish, they cannot understand. I am giving answer all the time. Sadhu Sangha, what is Sadhu Sangha, what is Sadhu Sangha? Everywhere, even Mayavadi Acharya Sankarajaja also speaking. Bhavati Bhavarnabe, Bhavati Bhavarnabo Tarune Nuka. Iha Jagati Sajjana Sangati Reka. Bhavati Bhavarnabo Tarune Nuka. Sangati Reka, the only procedure, the only procedure. Sankarajaja Mayavadi is speaking, the only procedure. Iha Jagati. Sajjana Sangati Reka. Bhavati Bhavarnava Tarane Nauka. To cross the material ocean, you will have to take shelter. Go to pure Sadhguru Vaishnava. Even Mayavad Acharya, Sankarajaja. But he is Vaishnavanam Jathasambhu. That's why he is guiding rightly. Maybe he is representing Mayavad, but here in this case, not speaking wrong. Iha Jagati is Sajjana Sangati Reka. In this material world, the only way open before you is to get the association of a pure sadhu, because that can act in your life as a boat to help you to cross the material ocean. But you are going to stop them to go to sadhu. You are going to stop good association? What is that? You are going to stop everybody to go for, don't go for satsanga. What is that? That we like to know. What is the case? Why we cannot go to a pure sadhu? Why? What is the reason? There can be two reasons. One is that if I can prove they are not at all sadhu, if you have your power, then you can prove they are not sadhu. Or maybe if we are going to admit them as sadhu, then you can discover my fault. Two alternative. Alternative one, alternative there. Why I cannot allow you to go to a sadhu? Why? If I know that in the name of sadhu you are going to somewhere else, then I can speak. Don't go there. Then I can say, don't go there. But I am sure that he is going to get sadhu sangha. Why I can speak, not go there? I have no right to stop anybody to go for sadhu sangha. Sadhu sangha is a must. Whereas Mayavad Acharya Sankaraja is speaking, but you are going to speak, don't go for sadhu sangha. Very dangerous. So in this Bhagavad Sloka, in Chaitanya Chaitamrita, where not, everywhere we can find this, you know, advice that you will have to go for sadhu sangha. Maharaj, you told one day that somebody going to ask Prabhupad, Prabhupad, we can go there for... Don't go there! Why Prabhupad speaking that way? Because we cannot get satsanga there. One condition Prabhupad putting in front of us, that if you are not going to get bad association, if you are not going to get, you know, namaparad, if you are not going to hear some namaparad, at all namabas going on, okay. It is namabas, not actually harikatha. It is namabas, okay, still you can go. But if there is namaparad, but now point is that how you can understand what is namaparad, what is actual harikatha? How you can understand? If you are really enjoying full kippah of Guru Varga, you can go and search all the writings written by Bhakti Vinod Thakur Prabhupada and all the writings written by all Guru Varga. Then you can find some disparity here. This Siddhanta is not good. This is totally wrong. In that case, you can understand. Wrong Siddhanta is not at all possible for a Siddha Mahatma. I am not speaking. Even Bhakti Vinod Thakur speaking long ago, 160 years back, Bhakti Vinod Thakur speaking. 160 years back. Any sadhu from any of the four sampradaya, Sadguru, on general topic, regarding rasa tattva, this is fine Siddhanta, I'm not speaking. Bhaktivinoda is speaking. Anything, advice given by one sadhu, he is at present staying in the north pole of this world. North pole. A genuine Sadguru, he is at present staying in the north pole of this world. He is speaking this, on this topic. And on this same topic, another Sadguru speaking, he is now staying in the south pole of this world. I am not speaking. Bhaktivinoda is speaking. Maybe representation is different. Maybe representation is different, but meaning is all same. It is not possible that Sadguru can speak this Sadguru, this Sadguru, on this general. Rasa Tattva may be different, they have their Siddhanta on. That is, I am not, in general way. Rasa Tattva all the time difference. I am not speaking, in general. He cannot find any disparity. All he is speaking, all the same what he is speaking, advice. Maybe representation is different. What is the symptom of a Sadguru? What is the symptom of a Satsisya? Many times I told, who is 100% in line with his Gurudev. Regarding Siddhanta, regarding Adarsha, regarding, you know, etiquette, everything, in toto, not even the slightest difference. That's why that yesterday I was speaking, no? The slightest deviation from the track of your Guru Padma can ultimately throw you away from Bhajan. As and when I am disconnected from the lotus feet of Guru Padma, I feel that I am a big monkey, I can jump, then problem coming. Then different kind of dissatisfaction, different kind of complaint, different kind of grievance can come and contaminated heart. I know the reason of fighting is ignorance. Okay. I am giving lecture in front of you. Maharaj, the only reason of any grievance, any fighting is ignorance. Okay, that I know. It is standing philosophy. But can you prove that ignorance is there, not inside me? You will have to prove, na? I can speak false philosophy. I can speak false philosophy, not spoken by Guru Varga, nothing. You cannot prove. All different kinds of, not at all spoken by Vishwanath Chakravarti Pad, not spoken by Rupa Goswami Pad, Jiva Goswami Pad, Prabhupad, Bhakti, not that kind of Siddhanta I'm speaking. What does it mean? This way you will have to be very sincere. In Gita, I can give you one reminder. In Gita, Bhagavan Sri Krishna speaking very nice way. Krishna Bhagavan speaking. That if you are 100% sincere to help yourself, then you can enjoy divine help coming. Divine help. All Guru Varga, all they gone. They all used to love me, I don't know the reason. Even the last, you know, Tibikam Maharaj, he used to bless me. I know you have nothing, but whatever you desire, that can come successful. He told me, I am in Vyasasan speaking, in Dakai language. In Dakai language speaking, Babaji Maharaj, sab hoya jaibo, ja chinta koriben sab hoye jaibo. Mane everything can come true. He wanted to speak, you can enjoy divine help. If there is no duplicity inside my heart, if there is no duplicity inside my heart, who is going to stop me? Nobody can stop. No power in this world. So Krishna in Gita speaking one thing. Udharet atmana atmana matman naiva avasadayat. You gone through Gita? No time. Udharet atmana atmanam natman naiva avasadayat. God helps them, those who help themselves. This thing. Those British men, English men, how they know the secrets, yeah? Eh? I wonder. They know. They're speaking this way, same thing. Eh? Same thing Krishna speaking, no? If you are sincere, to get real benefit, then be sure that Sadhguru is there, coming behind you to help you back in. Follow, you see. This way, actually, Supreme Lord is always there, Vallabhi Maharaj always there to back us that way. So, you see, so actually, all in different sastra, we can get the advice of satsanga. We cannot stop satsanga. Who is sadhu, who is not sadhu, you will have to understand, because we are not going to fight openly. This is not battlefield. We can pick up quarrel with people and fight with each other, like Jodhu Vangsa. That's why. We find one word in English philosophy, that charity begins at home. Charity begins at home. If you want to give some good, then you have to start from home. Follow. Foreign people, by now knowing something, but they actually about this intricate philosophy, intricate Siddhanta, they're not so aware. Previously, at present they are knowing something. So if you can change the mind of a Mayavadi, I can go to the exact meaning what I mean to say. You will have to inculcate, you will have to install bhakti. If you can go and change the heart of a Mayavadi, if you can go to South India, change the mood of those, you know, karmakandi people, then we can think. Prachar. See, in front of foolish people, I can speak so many things. Follow. In front of all those, they're backing big knowledge, cannot speak. That is a big danger. So now point is that, who is actual disciple, who is actual guru, sadguru, you will have to find all my previous Harikatha, you will have to go. Still I am going to give you a reminder. He is disciple, who is having same Siddhanta with reconciled totally with Gurudev. 100%. Not even a slightest, disparity cannot prove. Then be sure he is Sat Sisha. And he is also Sadguru. He is following a Sadguru, that's why he himself become a Sadguru. If you are not going to follow a Sadguru in toto, 100%, then you can never become a Sadguru. The only procedure to become a Sadguru is to follow a Sadguru. The only procedure. You have to follow a Sadguru wholeheartedly. Oh, Seva, Siddhanta, etiquette, all day and night. You are not going to, manufacture any Siddhanta. Mental concocted Siddhanta is not admitted. This way you can understand. When you can find the Sishya is totally harmonized with Gurudev, then if you can go through philosophy, you can find not even a single Siddhanta, which is just wrong Siddhanta. You cannot find a single Siddhanta, which is just wrong. Totally same. Because Siddhanta is not a matter of jugglery. I can make this muscle up, barbell every day. Prabhupada speaking, we cannot go to a gymnasium to learn Siddhanta. Siddhanta can automatically come inside your heart, provided you are going to follow your Guru Varga in toto, then all problem can be solved in your life. Now, from tomorrow, I can try to project the Siddhanta Prabhupada. In front of those disciples, Prabhupada is very craving mood, speaking very heavily. Prabhupada speaking that you should have the mood of humble attitude, very humble attitude. Always you try to remember that we are an instrument, not instrument player. Prabhupada giving. Many times I told, from Chaitanya Charitamrita, Raya Mahasaya Mahaprabhu, Raya Ramananda Sangbad going on. I am trying to translate into English, very trying, but what Seva can do? So there you can find, on the basis of the lecture given by Prabhupada, in Kobur, at the bank of Godavari, on the basis of that lecture, there's Bengali Raya Ramananda. Very nice, you can go mad if it is translated. There you can find in Chaitanya Charitamrita also that Raimukhe Bhakta Swayam Gaur Rai. Raimukhe Bhakta Swayam Gaur Rai. It seems Raya Ramananda going to speak, but not that. Chaitanya Mahaprabhu himself speaking in front of Raya Ramananda. Inside heart. Mahaprabhu sitting at heart and speaking all Siddhanta and hearing. Raya Mahasa himself confess. Raya Mahasa speaking, Prabhu, you are actually giving inspiration. You are actually speaking inside me. You are going to hear. Same thing Bhaktivinoda Thakur was singing in Kirtan. Same thing in Kirtan, Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking. This is the mood of actual Sadhu, Acharya. Bhaktivinoda Thakur writing, you must follow. Piyaya prem matto kori more suno nijo guno gaan. Hey Prabhu, you hear your own glory from my mouth. You play the instrument side and the music can come, you can enjoy. That is your capacity. It is not my capacity. Raya Mahasaya, same thing speaking, which Bhaktivinoda Thakur representing in Kirtan. Bhaktivinoda Thakur speaking very nicely there. That Piyaya Prem Matto Kori More Suno Nijo Guno Gaan. Hey Prabhu, you are trying to hear your own glory. And you are giving me nectar to drink. I am drinking nectar. I am losing my material consciousness. I am losing my consciousness means I am growing full consciousness. Follow. I am losing material consciousness. Now I am like one drunkard. I am singing and you are already hearing your own glories. That is your capacity, Prabhu. Raya Mahasaya is speaking this way. I am instrument. You are playing that instrument and hearing all Siddhanta from me. Who am I? That is the actual mood of a preacher. Analytically, it can go on speaking, you can go mad. Prabhupada almost crying and praying in front of us. If we are going to lose this humble attitude doesn't mean that I can stop speaking absolute truth. Humble attitude doesn't mean I can misguide you and earn the name I am very soft acharya. Not that. This is not. So actually, there you see, Prabhupada speaking, we are all instrument of that Supreme Lord. The way He wants to play inside there, inside our heart, He can play, we can go on. We should not express any vanity, we should not express any proud. Many times I told, those who are actual Gauriya. I am proud to speak that I am from Gauriya Math. I like to put red cloth here and speak, advertise, I am from Gauriya Math. I am from Gauriya Math. I am in the parampara Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati. I feel proud. That is not ignorance. I want to project the philosophy of Prabhupada. I want to sing in thousands of mouth if I get an ear. I like to hear about Prabhupada. I like to speak about Prabhupada. I cannot conceal the Siddhanta spoken by Prabhupada. It is my resolution in my life. So I feel proud I am from Gauriya Math. So secrecy, so secret treasure, nowhere in this whole universe you can show, I can live my best. I can throw my best, that is if you can prove. So great treasure there waiting for us. But we are so foolish, we are going to mind very, very small things. a life of a sadhu. A sadhu is always international. You cannot say this sadhu is from this group, this sadhu is from me. You are idiot, you are politician. You should not speak that way. A sadhu is always international sadhu, because he is serving for whole world. A sadhu, a scientist, a doctor is international always. You cannot confine him inside your country. A sadhu is always international. He is serving for whole world. That's why we find one nice, darshan. Jalani tasam na pibanti nadyaha. You can remember, someday I told, maybe 6-8 months before. Jalani tasam na pibanti nadyaha. I told you, no? Those rivers, they are not going to drink their own water. Phalani tasam na khadant bikshaha. Nadanti sasyani megha kadachit. Paropukarayo satam vibhuti. Why you become angry with me? You are not sadhu? Maybe I have done something wrong to you. It is your duty to excuse me. That day I was speaking, na? Kokilanam smaro rupam narinam pativratam vidya rupam kurupanam and khama rupam tapasinam. Thousands of times I will have to excuse. Maybe you have insulted me. But I should not chase you that way. That is not Vaishnava line. You are totally wrong. You are totally wrong. You are totally wrong. I cannot chase. It's totally wrong. It's not good. Jalanita sam na pivanti nadya. Phalanita sam na pivan na khadanti biksha nadanti sasyani megha kadachi paropkaraya satam vibhuti. Satam vibhuti, those who are sadhu, their knowledge, their power, their excellency, all for the service of Supreme Lord, all for your service. I have no desire to deserve something. I have my power. I have no power to deserve. Because those who are actual Gauriya, those who are actual Gauriya, those who are actual Gauriya sadhus, acharyas, they always think everything coming from the top source, the lotus feet of Balaram. Balaram means Baladhikyat Balam Vidu, all power we are getting from Balaram. Who is there to stop? Let them try to stop us. They can burn up. Balaram can. Balaram is topmost powerful, more than Krishna. He can stop. Hey, stop! Your brother, you are dog. Balaram can stop Krishna. Stop! Don't speak. So powerful. We have Balaram Kipa with us. Mean Guru Kipa. Balaram mean Anantadev. The time you are disconnected from Anantadev, the time you are disconnected from the lotus feet of your Sadguru, you can feel different kind of dissatisfaction, different kind of grievance can cover up your heart. Cover up your heart means your chitball can go down. You cannot stand with chitball. You can see, you can look at one sadhu. By what power are you speaking this way? No money power, no organization, nothing. That means that power coming from there. That's why speaking. He never fear any power in this world. He never fear. No, somebody going against him, they can burn up themselves. Balaram can devastate their organization if they're going to. That is the commitment of Balaram. Balaram Ji Maharaj speaking. And Prabhupada also giving this kind of statement. Balaram Ji Maharaj speaking. Pashunam loguro yatha. Those who are beast, those who are seas, those who are showing their activities like a beast, for them one danda is sufficient. Balaji Maharaj speaking about Dujjadhan. Pashunam Laguro Yatha. He is not going to obey. Then Lagur, Balaji Maharaj can beat, give Lagur on them. They can understand. Pashunam Loguru Yatha. And Prabhupada also declaring, those who are dedicated soul for the absolute truth, they can speak openly. No fear, without any fear. Because if anybody is going to attack, that absolute truth can come down to protect that devotee. Because his life is dedicated for that absolute truth. Tomorrow I can discuss, but Prabhupada wants to speak. Follow? You cannot speak about that absolute truth until and unless you are 100% dedicated. I can speak about this point. So now point is that this way we will have to understand gradually. Like those rivers not at all going to drink their own water. They are giving, you know, this water for you all. And those fruits in the trees, and any trees, they are giving to you. You can eat, you can offer to Krishna. The trees, they are not going to take any fruits. They are producing in their... And those crops there in the field, you can discover. Or clouds can never deserve. Due to we are there in the sky, clouds, we are giving rain. That's why crops, they are growing crops. That's why you have to give me share. Never speaking. Never speaking that way. You will have to give me share. Not speaking that way. All yours. This is the life of sadhu. How to detect foolish number one. How to understand. How to understand who is sadhu. This is the mood. You can find my life is for you all. Another example, our Guru Varga used to give a candle going to give light to others, but gradually burning up. Candle. Wax candle giving light. He is gradually going to... If I am a man, if I am not at all a beast, then I should cry. To see the life history of Prabhupada, the activities of Prabhupada. If I am at all man, if I am not at all beast, I will have to cry. At the age of 62, if I look at Prabhupada, I will have to die. I like to die. What is the condition of Prabhupada? Whole day and night Prabhupada giving everything for us. I am such a big traitor. I am such a big traitor. Enemy. Of Gaudiya Math, enemy of Prabhupada. I like to go different way. You have to cry if you see the picture of Prabhupada at the age of 62. All gone. Prabhupada health already gone, going to leave body for us. Whole day and night, not rest, nothing. If you are going to cut this parampara, then you are going to cut your own throat. Be careful. You are going to commit suicide. 100%. Nobody can protect. Be careful about this point. So now from tomorrow I can speak that what Prabhupada used to say, what Prabhupada want to speak, Bhakti Siddhanta Saraswati or Siddhanta. It is the teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. Exact teachings of Chaitanya Mahaprabhu. From tomorrow, I can go on speaking all about the secrecy. You will have to get preparation to face absolute truth. To face absolute truth, I must have some power. If you have some hidai durvallo, weakness, anartha, you cannot hear this kind of harikatha. You have to stop. Vancha kalpaturvasya kipa sindh bhavishya patitanang pavanabho vashyam bhyo namo. Also, that sloka I started with, I can explain tomorrow. Today, no time. One question, different kind of question coming in internet from different country. Yesterday, one question coming from America. I don't know whose disciple is he. He is speaking that I am hearing the Harikatha of ShyamBaba continuously. His internet is there with him. He is blessing to those who are giving this Harikatha internet. It's written there. I am not taught, I am thinking the maybe his condition is good, otherwise I cannot expect this kind of remark. Now he is putting question that we heard from ShyamBaba's Harikatha, also from other Mahajan, that when Jivatma trying his own best to go up and up by own effort, ultimately he can fall down. Arujya krichena parampadam tataha patati adha anadrita jusmat angrahyo. Why he is fallen down? Because he is not going to give value to the eternal existence of the lotus feet of Supreme Lord. He is going to avoid the service of eternity, of the service of Supreme Lord and Guru Vishnu. He agrees this point. Now he is going to put this question, some acharya speaking, that while that jivatma is going to submerge with this impersonal Brahma, I mean Brahma Sajujyo. Sajujyo, two types of Sajujyo there. One is Brahma Sajujyo with impersonal Brahma, another is the Supreme Lord, lotus feet, like Shushupal. Second one is more dangerous. Second one is very dangerous. Anyway, I can discuss someday, now no time. Gradually I like to discuss about, because it's very urgent. Now, he is very, suspicious about the Siddhanta. One Siddhanta there, he finds that from Brahmajyoti, somebody, some Jivatma can go up to Goloka or Vaikuntha. He is asking me, Maharaj Vadi, how he can go? Is it good or not? Or I heard about Jiva's bonded condition and in Anadi Bahirmukh, some Acharya writing in such a way, I was very sorry to admit this kind of discussion. After that he told, I discussed this point, I gone through some writings of some Maharaj from South India, he is from foreign country. Okay, this kind of, he is giving some example of Vrindavan also, I don't like to name. Only duty, my duty is to solve this solution. Now he is asking, is it possible that Acharya speaking, sometime some Jivatma can from Brahmajyoti can go up? I say, actually in my whole life, in never no Siddhanta I find this. If at all some Acharya going to speak, it is his business, I don't know. I am very small child in front of him, I don't like to pass any remark. But one nice Siddhanta I can speak. First I can put question in front of you, what do you mean by submerging into impersonal Brahma? I want to get answer from you. What is the answer? You can easily speak like child, Maharaj is very easy. You can go and submerge with Brahma, it is an inactive situation, passive situation. Follow, passive. No activities there, nothing there. But you cannot say that Jivatma, like Mayavadi speaking, that Jivatma can go and become Brahma. No! I can give one example. I can give one nice example that there in front of you, there in front of me, I find a dense forest, green and green. Follow what I mean to say, try to understand. In front of me, I find a dense forest, green and green everywhere. Suddenly, one very green bird going to enter into that bush. Then, where is that bird gone? I cannot find. Follow. But that doesn't mean that bird already converted into forest. Not that. The bird is having his external, eternal existence. But here, in this condition. Same example I can give. Someday, if you give me scope to discuss about Mayavad, you can laugh, if you can start laughing, the Siddhanta of Mayavadi. Someday if you give me scope, by the mercy, by your mercy, I can go on discussion, you can you can start laughing. This is the Siddhanta of Mayavadi. Follow. Now my point is that, some Acharya speaking, that Jivatma can go up and reach Vaikuntha. Not all. Now my first question is that to submerge with impersonal Brahma means to achieve inactive position, passive situation. And you know, even a child know, that all human beings going to suffer or enjoy their result of activities, what they have done before. Follow? Avashyameva bhaktavyam kritakarma subhasubham. I told you. Surely you will have to suffer what you have done. Your father not going to cut you. Your mother, your husband, nobody. You will have to suffer what you have done in your life. If this be the situation, now my question is that when Jivatma trying and trying best to submerge with that impersonal Brahma, that is called passive situation. Follow? Passive. Passive situation means there is no activity. Like mathematics I am speaking. It is passive situation mean no activities. Passive situation means there is no activities. If there is no activities, then where from this result can come? The result cannot come. Which can drive him up or down? Follow my point. That man is so intelligent, originally he is from India. Bengali. He is American citizenship. Also here. He is putting question, the how possible Maharaj, what force driving him up to Golok? Could you please claim? I say, I never heard this one. I heard it from there, someday they can fall down and again they can get their activities and gradually if they are going to get good association, gradually they can know. This Siddhanta I never heard. So, follow my point. So this is the clear answer I like to speak. No Siddhanta Virod, nothing. I have no vanity, no false ego that I will have to establish my Siddhanta. Why? If I am in parampara, I can discuss this point. Srautapantha means you have no right to change any Siddhanta. Srautapantha means you are totally in line. If you are going to derailed, then you are surely not in Srautapantha. All your interpretation, everything wrong. Siddhanta. Be careful. So this part of this Harikatha, after Vanchakalpatu, you can send to the man. Follow? Vanchakalpaturusike pasinde bhavacha patitanam pavane bhavishna bhyo namo kota baje ha 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 ha.
How is it that in life you want to do spiritual work and go up, but then there's always something bringing you to material desires?
It is the only reason behind is that it is true. When I started bhajan, I started with some humble mood. Maybe. Because material situation, try to follow what I mean to say. Maybe my situation, material situation is so painful. I was feeling pain. How to go out? That's why in that time some demand of getting free was there. In true sense. But after that, suddenly, I get this opportunity. Brahmanda Bhamita Gona Bhagavanji, Guru Krishna was. Then by chance, some Guru Vaishnava causeless mercy giving on me. When that power coming in me, then I gradually started thinking that that power is coming from me. Follow my point. Again I think this power, I can forget that so painful situation is there in my family life. So I wanted to suicide. From that situation, Balaram, rescue me. How it is possible that Balaram is changing my situation and I become again popped up? And who are you? Who is Vaishnava? No Vaishnava there. Don't go there. Then again I can fall down with all my groups. This is the condition for why. That is why Vrindavan Das Thakur Maharaj is speaking, if Shankar Bhagavan is there, if Sulopani Samajudi hai, if he is going to make any Vaishnava Parash, he will have to suffer. Otherwise, no respite, no way out. This is the only condition. Without any Vaishnava Parash, without any offense, my brain cannot go out of order. Because you already hear simple Siddhanta from Gita. Dhyato vishana pungsham sangastesu pujayate sangyat sangyat kamaha kamat krodho vijayate krodhat bhavati sanmaha sanmohat siti vibhram sad buddhinasa buddhinasat pranasami. infatuation, total loss of memory, all can occur in your life and it can make you totally isolated from the lotus feet of your Gurudev. Please excuse me. I am bound to speak that way, to save you all. I have no attitude to fight with anybody. Vanchakalpodarojjaki pasindabhaj. Patitanang pavana bhavishna bhyo namo. Then no need. I already told.
Yes, but one can demand or one can say, oh, I'm doing Krishna Bhajan, so I don't need to do any activity because I'm doing Krishna Bhajan. I don't care of others. One can say because I'm doing Krishna Bhajan, then I don't.
But that Krishna Bhajan should be perfect. Foolish. If I am speaking about ideal thing. Yatha taran muli, you are doing Krishna Bhajan apparently, but you are thinking about material relationship, I am all busy. All your activities, you are doing Krishna Bhajan means all your activities should be related to Krishna Bhajan. Follow. Your going to school should be in favor of bhakti. Foolish, try to understand what I speak. Your eating should be in favor of bhakti. Your sitting should be in favor of bhakti. Your walking should be in favor of bhakti. Can we have that kind of intelligence here? You can relate everything with Krishna Bhajan, then you are doing Krishna Bhajan. Otherwise you will have to follow. But still better, still good. You are trying to do Krishna Bhajan. You have to learn how to attain perfection. I am discussing show secrecy. Thus, you can go mad. If you have no digestion power, you can fight with me. Follow. Banchagal.